G'day, I'm Clive and welcome. Been over 3 years since I've been using this Snugpak Special Forces Bivvi bag. We'll have a quick look at it, go over all the specs, general chit chat saying what I think of it, how I've got on with it, and all that sort of thing. The things that a normal review, my first review, I wasn't able to do because I hadn't had over a year's experience of using it, but now I've had over 3 years experience of using it, so I'm able to tell you a little bit more, show you a little bit more, and just show you how good this is. So got it all written down here, do the easy bit. Now it does come in a little stuff sack, and that measures, when it's all in there, 10 centimeters by 15 centimeters. It just go in. I just stuff it in, give it a squeeze, pull the cord out the top, and it's there. Now, with doing this room, I can't find it. It's probably in one of the boxes down below, or in one of the canvas bags down here. I've got the little bag it comes in, the stuff sack, has got mesh at the bottom, so if you are putting it straight back in there and it is a bit wet, it's going to help air it out. It's not going to air it out completely because you've got like a nylon actual stuff sack, but it will help because you've got the mesh at the bottom. And also what you've got on the bottom of the little stuff sack that comes with it is a little Velcro strap, so you can actually strap that onto your pack. If you've got molly webbing, you can put it through your molly webbing, strap it and hang it on the outside of your pack or on your shoulder strap, or put a carabiner and hook it on a backpack or hiker's backpack, anywhere. So it's easy to use. The cord lock, as I remember, isn't one of those little tiny ones you get on some. It's a fair size, probably over half an inch, 15 millimeter size cord lock. So you can grip hold of it, even with a pair of gloves on, to open it or to close it back up. But without, that's an A5 pad, and that's without even being condensed down, that's just rolled and folded a little bit. It can be folded a bit more with a bit of effort. So now it's about half the size. What have we got? Waterproof rating on this is a 5000 millimeter hydrostatic head. And in the tent world and tarp world and everything, if you can get a hydrostatic head of 1500 and above, that is classed as waterproof. So at 5000 hydrostatic head, that's pretty damn waterproof. What else have we got down here? Now this is important bit. Even though this material is called a breathable material, Snugpak recommend you don't do it all the way up, because it's not breathable as in you being able to do it up completely and breathe in there, because you will suffocate. When I say it is breathable, it will transmit up to 7.5 litres of moisture per square metre per 24 hours. So that really means it's going to reduce the condensation in it, or stop the condensation. Now on that point, never ever had condensation in this, whether I've used the jungle bag or I've used a down top quilt which is rated down to -7 degrees centigrade or 20 degrees Fahrenheit. Never had any condensation in this bag up to now. Putting it away, I've never zipped it all the way up and put my mouth inside so I could breathe. So the breathability for the moisture is good. What else we got? Let's see, weight. It comes in at 340 grams. Now I've never actually measured that, so I don't know if that's in the stuff sack or not. So there we go, let's grab the scales. is always good for me as well to do an update. Let's get this on. That there. Set it at zero. Put that in there. As it is out of the stuff sack, 312 grams. So that's a saving of, what did I say? 340? So it's a saving of 28 grams, just taking it out of the stuff sack. So in that sense, I saved 28 grams because I don't carry it in the stuff sack anymore. All right. What else do we need to know now? These are taped seams. So all the seams are taped on the inside. So where it's all stitched up, it's going to be waterproof. So no water is going to come through. Yes. Okay, we'll get it out and we'll show you. The length. The full length is 230 for the regular one. Centimeters in length, 88 across the chest and 65 across the foot box. Now they do an extra large, which is 260 centimeters in length, but then it's got the same chest of 88 and the same foot box of 65. You're just gaining that extra 30 centimeters or extra foot, 12 inches of length. I don't think there's anything else on there we need to look at. Blah, 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 blah. No, that's all done. Let's put that over there. Now you can see I haven't stuffed it. I haven't squashed it. I just rolled it and folded. Now, back and front is, let's fill that and check that, is one piece. So it's actually stitched down the side here and around the foot box. And then the top is a separate piece of material. So across here, where the two halves meet, the stitching is really nice. It's tape sealed. You can actually see the tape from here where it's stuck to the back of this material. All the way around. So, and the same down the sides here, we've got tapes all the way around on the inside, sealing that, making it waterproof. And at the top, where it's wrapped around, again, nice stitching, tape sealed, waterproof. Yep, it's just folded over, so there's two pieces there. And that head piece is part of that, so it's two pieces to make the main part up. We have a zip which goes down halfway. Now, they say this Snugpak is suitable for any center zipped sleeping bag, like their special forces sleeping bags and everything. I don't have a center zip sleeping bag anymore. The main one I use is this one here, the Snugpak jungle bag. And even though it's a side zip, I've got room in here to get my arm around, undo the center zip and get in and out with ease. The head opens up really big, plenty of space there. So here's the seams, really nice stitching. I don't know if you can see on the camera, you can just see the actual print or the shape of the tape going behind. That's on the inside. Now this is the center zip, which comes all the way up to this point here. Now if I show you this folded over, we've got one main flap that folds all the way over, but not all the way at the bottom. And then we've got a second flap on either side. And this is folded over and stitched, folded over. And if you haven't seen my first video after a year's use, what this is like a weather flap. Similar to what the tents are doing now. So when the wind blows, when it's raining, it hits there and runs off, instead of just hitting the flat piece, coming over, landing down the zip, and soaking through the zip. So that is a smart little extra there. Again, there's a stitching, the flap, stitching, the flap, all the way up to the zip pull, and then that one will fold over. So if we get wind and rain that way, it doesn't go in. Wind and rain goes this way, even if it pulls that flap over, this is being blown over the zip and stopping the rain, or reducing the amount of wet and rain which will get to the zip and soak in. Zips, not branded, but they've never ever failed on me. Now if you don't, or if you're not aware of this, just with general care, when you're getting it, make sure you fasten it down, fold it over, put it away. Try not to keep it all scrunched up. But the zips, very little wear on them for over 3 years. They're basically, they're just as good as new. If anything, they're working better now than they did when I got it as new. But we've got poorly on the outside one. And we've got another zipper on the inside one. I just wish they'd put another pulley on there, just makes it easier at night. And if I turn it over, we've got all the tape seam down here, which is sealing all the stitching to stop the rain coming through. Again around here, all nice and tidy. I did have a couple of loose threads here where they hadn't trimmed it off, so I just trimmed them back myself. But all in all, oh, I found one more there, which is part of the tag. And what's this one say? Yeah, made in the UK, this one. Up this end here, there's a pulley, a line lock, big enough to use it with and without gloves if you need to. And I like this bit here, something to hold onto. Now that's like a power cord, it's only about 3 or 4 mil. As you can see there, there's very little wear or tear on that, if any. So if we pull this cord, it tightens up and cinches it. But because the material is so light, you can't just give it a yank, because it does get caught here with a line knot. So what I do is I just slowly work it around to where I need it at night, and then I'll do it up. But that does cinch up to a hole like this, just enough for your nose and mouth to stick out. Now, have I ever had any moisture get in? No, I've had no issues with rain, moisture, whatever you want to call it, getting in. None of the stitching has let water in. It has got wet. Most of the time when I'm using this, if I'm not in like a three-sided shout on the bivvy track, I'll just have my tarp, which covers me from this area above my head. Doesn't matter about this end getting wet. I'm still able to open this end in the dry, sit up, lay down, and go back to sleep. Temperature rating. Now, the bivvy bag doesn't have its own temperature rating, but what I can say is what I have noticed over using it for over 3 years now. The For example, the Snugpak jungle bag there is rated down to about 7 degrees centigrade, which is, what's that, 20 degrees Fahrenheit-ish. And that is fairly accurate on that. Using this, it all depends on what sleep mat I've got. But I have taken that down to around the 2 degrees centigrade in this and been comfortable. Could I take it lower? I think so. Yes, I do think so. But at times, even with just that, I've had to unzip the bivvy bag because I got too warm. And that's the advantage of this center zip. It helps as a regulator, a temperature regulator or heat regulator. So what I notice a few times I have done in the night is when I've been too hot, I've unzipped it, flap these over just to let the heat out and to cool myself down. Is it big enough to sleep with your sleeping bag and your sleeping mat in there? Now, I'm 5'6", I'm not skinny, and I've used this when I was quite a few more kilos overweight. I was able to sleep in here with my sleeping bag and my inflatable sleep mat and still have room to move around and not feel restricted. So that's me personally. I couldn't say whether you will or not. It all depends on you, how you feel in tighter situations, or if that doesn't bother you, you may be happy to put a big winter sleep mat in there. It all depends on you. But I was able to have my sleeping bag, my inflatable sleep mat in there, and still be very comfortable. What else? Not much more can be said. I've had great nights in this. I really do like it. It's one that if somebody said to me, if you had to get rid of everything, all your bivvy bags and keep one, what would that one be? This would be the one. Now I've got this one, 4 or 5 bivvy bags. I like them all, but this is the one I would keep. Yep. Now, the reason I don't have it in the little stuff sack, and I probably, like I said, it's in one of the boxes or bags somewhere, is I don't store it in there anymore. Even when I'm using it, I don't have it in there. What I normally do is turn this like into a swagman roll. So I'll have my sleep mat in there, I'll have my sleeping bag in there, and it depends on the sleeping bag. Sometimes the sleeping mat is inside the sleeping bag. And my actual pillow will stay in there, let down all the inflatable stuff, fold this over, roll it up, and just stuff it in the bottom of my pack. Now, my main pack is a 40-litre Helicontex Summit backpack. And even with it, with the sleeping bag, I've had it with the down, which goes even smaller. I've had it in with the jungle bag there, with the sleep mat in it, which has been the Sea to Summit one. This has been the main one I've used in there. That's been in there with the sleeping bag. Rolled it up, put it in the bottom, and it's gone in with ease. I was going to say, not a lot really. I just do like this bivvy bag. So if you're after something that's light, simple, no poles to break, nowhere where you have to put pegs in there to hold it in place, nowhere to hold the toes up, there's something you want to be able to get in, have ease of getting in and out, like same with the center zip that gives you that, this I would say is probably the bivvy bag for you. So the only downfall is when you're cinching the head bit up, and that's not really a negative. At the same time, once that's set up most nights, if I'm using it for multi days, I don't adjust that, so I just set it up the once and I forget it. and that actually helps hold the sleeping mat in place. It helps hold my pillow in place so that doesn't go slipping around at night. So yeah, it's a pretty decent bivvy bag. So I hoped, after me rambling on for this, what, 10, 15, however long minutes, showing you this and talking about it, you enjoyed the video. And if you're not already a subscriber, please go down below and click on that subscribe button. Click on the notification button next to it and select all. And that way you'll be notified of all future videos. And hit the like button, the thumbs up. And if you are already a subscriber, again, I thank you very much.